Good evening and welcome to the Business Hour on Fusion Plus TV. In the studio tonight, I have with me a special guest, and she's come with part of her fashion house, Jumoke Ali, and she's come here today with some of her models, and they're going to show us and talk to us more about fashion, Afro fashion, and the business of fashion. Jumoke, good evening. It's a pleasure. How are you?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
You know, I've waited a long time to actually have you on this show. And that's because every time I see you, I look at your earrings, I look at your tops, I think, what is she coming with next? Last time I saw you, you had this hood on. And I was like, where is all this creativity coming from? But before we get into the show, I want you to just tell me a bit about yourself. Are you a full-time fashion designer? Have you been doing this for 50 years? You know, tell us about you. Who is Jumoke Ali?
Okay. Well, my name is Jumoke Ali.
Okay.
And I have been doing fashion for most of my life, really.
Okay.
I just started to do it as a business 2 years ago.
Okay.
And I've always been different, you know, like I just edgy and just different from my peers. And I remember one day, I work as an IT consultant.
Okay.
And I was wearing my bespoke shirt to work, and a sister friend of mine just said, Auntie, I don't know what you're doing. Why you're not making this into a business? Because you really have unique styles. And the light bulb kind of went up there and said, okay, I can do this, you know. And that's when I started Arachnid Creations. And we've been doing cutting-edge styles, trending styles. I like to travel.
Okay.
And everywhere I go, I look at what is in trend in that country, and I kind of, you know, put my stamp on it and make it really unique, out of the box. I always say that if you want to be a wallflower, I'm not a designer for you.
Okay.
If you want to stand out from the crowd and you want to turn heads, so to speak, and something that is different, something people will really say, where did you get that from? You know, that's me. I like to think outside of the box. So my what I do is I love African prints. I mean, if you look at African prints, it's so beautiful. It's, you know, it's an inspiration itself. It just gets your creative juices going. But what I've done is I've merged African prints mm-hmm. with trendy styles. So we do jumpsuits, we do hoods, like you said, mm-hmm. you've seen me hoods, we mm-hmm. do skater dresses. But we merge it in such a way we cater for every market. For people who don't want to go so bold as to wear everything African print, we cater for that market. For people who just want to, just a little, you know, symptoms of it, we cater for that crowd. But, you know, we'll see later, Sam.
Okay. Oh, all right. Let me ask you this, right?
Okay.
Okay. The moment you started to speak about fashion, your eyes just went on. It was like a light bulb. I was like, ding. Yeah. So I can see that the fire is there. But I have a question.
Yes.
This fashion, this urban thing, how is the community taking it? I mean, is it competition for Oxford Street, or is it complementing Oxford Street? Is this something that is online? Is this something that is just done in a back shop? How is the wider community embracing people like you? So you and maybe other fashion designers, you know, what do you think the feel is in the market today for your
type? I think the market is ready for fashion like mine. You said if we're competing with Oxford Street, I would say yes, and we're on par with them. And I know I'm not on a big scale, I'm not as mm-hmm. big as them. Mm-hmm. But if you look at styles, it's just what's in trend. But I would say more cutting edge, because I always tell people, our African prints, people have cut on. The Oxford Street, mm-hmm. in quotes, they've cut on. They're repackaging this and selling it back to us, which is a shame, because I was walking down the shopping mall, and I saw Adire, which is called Tie and Dye, mm-hmm. the Guinea brocade, and he was in shorts and a shirt, and he was like going for 100 and something. I'm like, wow, I used to do this back home. People are saying it, that, you know, there's beauty in our fabrics, and we have different fabrics, not just the Ankara. We have Ashoke, which is called like the Kente. We have the Guinea brocade. We have different beautiful print that is handmade. I mean, look at what I'm wearing. It's so colorful, so bright. Mm-hmm. So I would say that we're on par. The world is starting to recognize African designers because we're blowing the fashion world out of the waters with our...
Okay.
Absolutely. And we are right there with them.
Okay.
So, yes, I mean, once you see some of our styles, I mean, I would say you judge for yourself. I can be as bold to say you judge for yourself and tell me whether okay. you think we're on par. But I think we're on par. I think soon, you know, people and how we've been received very well. You know, from any, I say my our designs are for people who are trendy, ages, you know, from teenagers to, you know, anyone can wear it. Not just Africans, by the way. Europeans have worn my outfits. We're going to show one style, a kimono inspired outfit, and it's been worn to party. I've seen it everywhere. So
really?
Yes. So it's not just for Africans. It's for, you know, it's something that, it's a fashion that cuts across the world. It's global. And that's why I'm happy about it. I don't want to restrict our designs to just our people. Even though I love our people.
Okay. Okay.
Yes. Yeah, but, you know, what I like is about the African, like I said, African design is blowing, you know, trains out of the waters. We're just going out there and doing our thing. And you get it, like I said, I get inspiration even when I went to back home and the market women, you know, one time there was a thing about color blocking. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, color blocking first happened in Africa. It first did. I'm telling you, because when you go to Africa and then you go to the marketplace with the background of the peppers and the vegetables, you see this old women with different pieces of ankara. And they have red head wraps that is different from the fabric. It kind of just works together. You see the bus conductor with ankara wearing ankara inside and wearing a coat with hood. And it just gets you thinking, wow, okay, nobody's looking at them, but I am. And sometimes okay. that's where I get my... yeah.
Okay. You know what? 2 weeks ago, we were all at Women for Africa.
Yes.
And... normally, I love my fashion, mm-hmm. and when I speak to a designer, I get my clothes ready about a month before, so I can look at it, make sure it's what I like.
Yes.
But this time around, the fashion designer I used, unfortunately, his father had a serious, I think, operation, so he couldn't bring my clothes to me till 11 p.m. the night before. Friday night, 11 p.m., got to my house, and for the first time, I saw what I was going to wear. And to me, it was a big shock, because I was like, wow, what is this? But you saw what I wore, and not now, but later on, I want you to comment on it, because I still look back at it and think, what is this? It was, you know, it really hit me. I kept on looking at, what am I wearing?
Yeah.
But listening to what you're saying, it does flash back to me that maybe this is the whole new trend that you're speaking about. So I really want to, you know, if I had it here, I would have put it on for you viewers.
Yeah.
But fortunately, I don't have to model. You don't have to model because you've come with two models that are going to showcase some amazing stuff that you've made. And we're talking about dresses.
Dresses
and
shirts, and we even have raincoats.
And you've got an African raincoat.
Absolutely.
Look, someone needs to tweet this.
Yes.
When this comes, I need to take a picture of this. You have an African raincoat in this studio.
I promise you. Yeah.
You promise?
Yes.
On TV.
On TV.
Okay. What we're going to do? We're going to take a very short break.
Okay.
And when we come, I would like my viewers to see this African raincoat.
Okay.
So don't go away, we'll be back in a minute.
When you're looking for a solicitor to deal with your case, you don't just look for any solicitor, you look for the right solicitor. An expert who knows what he's doing can deal with your case the right way, achieving the best results. Hubaski Solicitors has more than 100 years of specialist experience serving the local community in immigration law, property law, human rights legislation, civil and criminal litigation, family law, employment law, Sharia law, business law, maritime and commercial law, providing professional legal services globally in Africa, Asia, and Europe. Be assured, we'll be able to deal with your case the absolute right way with results. So, contact us today by phone on 020-7739-7549 or go online at www.legalpal.com.
Okay, we are back, and Jumoke said she's going to give us a raincoat made of Ankara.
Yes.
So it's time for you to do your Accra Badabra.
Yes.
And introduce this thing for our viewers. So over to you.
Okay, thanks, Sam. Here I have my beautiful model, Bonnie. Bonnie is wearing a raincoat. This is waterproof material, but we've embellished it with Ankara. So even though if it rains, it's not gonna, you'll still remain all dry, but it's, if you turn back, Bonnie, thank you so much. It's embellished with Ankara, and you know, everything is, this is Ankara, I mean about African prints. And it's got a hood. Bonnie, do you wanna put on the hood? So, wow. So, I mean, we don't have to make raincoat boring. You know, you go out, it's raining, but you still wanna stand out. You know what I mean? You still want to
say. I have to close my lips. I have to eat my hat.
Yeah, you still want to stand out, and you still. So we. I mean, you can have this in any color you want. You've got pink. You've got yellow. You've got, you know, different colors. You can use it. We use it. We put it underneath there, and we put a raincoat material over it, so that when you're out and about, you can still look stylish. But if you take off the raincoat for me, please, I just want to reveal what is underneath. We've kind of layered everything. So what I like to do is that we do this 3-in-1 outfits, 4-in-1 outfits that you can, wherever you go, if you want, by peeling off a layer, you can reveal a different outfit. I call it the science, the arachnid of science, the science of arachnid. Mm. I say let us arachnify you. So like, for example, if I just put that on the floor, Bonnie is wearing such a kind of futuristic look. This is a skirt and a crop top. And yeah, and you know, if you think about it, you can mix and change things as you like. If you don't want to wear the skirt, you can wear jeans with it and just wear the top. I mean, I see someone going to work with this, with your computer bag, and that is if you take off the top, if you want to, take off the top. Let's let the viewers see what is underneath. So, I mean, you can go this way, if you don't have to use the jacket. And again, we've just embellished this woven. We've woven Ankara, different kinds of Ankara into this. So you can do this. You can remove the skirt, just wear jeans. That's it. And if you want to go to work, you can just wear this, put a black top in like she has, or like a shirt with collar. And Bob's your uncle. My daughter said not to say that, but Bob's your uncle. And you have another outfit. I mean, look at beautiful Adeola. She's wearing a skirt. We've picked up the same African print there. And the good thing about it, she's wearing a corset on top of it. Now, we ladies, we like to cinch our waist end. We like the hourglass figure. You want that hourglass figure. You want to go to for a night out. That's it. You wear that, you cinch it in, you wear killer heels, you can wear a crop jacket, you're gone. And you know what? The good thing is the corset is removable. You can remove the corset and you have another separate outfit. So if you bear with us, yeah. There you go, nearly there. That's it. And you have another outfit.
Completely different outfit.
A different outfit. And this, I say, you know, you want to go for a walk? You want to go for, I mean, we want to go to work, not for a walk. You want to go to work for dinner, for, you know, it's just a different look, you know, and you want to put a corset in to look, you know, give yourself a bit of va-va-voom. I say, why not? I always say, you know, on my Twitter, I say, every time I put my pictures and I say, hashtag.
What is your Twitter?
It's called arachnid at J. Ali. J. Ali at Arachnid, sorry.
J. Ali at Arachnid.
That's our Twitter.
That's your Twitter. Okay.
Yes. you know, I always say hashtag dare to be different. I say, you know, because I go to work in this, you know, I go to work in my shirts. So say, for example, I'm wearing this and I want to tone it down. I just wear a black crop top on top of it. Nobody even looks at me. That's the thing. Fashion cuts across. You can wear it anywhere too. We want to create a fashion that you can wear to work. You can wear for play, for shopping, for barbecue, big party. And I promise you something. You see our outing party, our statement piece.
You're promising me again.
I'm promising you, Sam.
Okay.
And just going back to what you said, you know, about sizes, you know, by the way, what you were wearing for Women Africa was brilliant. I mean, it's right up my street, sorry.
Right.
Yes. I mean, I love the fact that they've just picked up the kente, I think the fabric on the lapel.
Yes.
And you have it, you know, on the in the trousers as
yes.
well. We cater for UK sizes and European sizes. So whatever size you are, size 12, 14, 16, what we do it.
Six, eight.
It's six. Oh, yeah. Okay. Look at the six
okay,
and eight.
Okay.
Don't mind them. I'm just joking. So we cater for all the different sizes. And I mean, of course, you know, they're very tall. You know, if you want it longer, you know, we cater for different sizes. So, yeah, just to answer the question that you said before.
Okay, I have less to say and more to look.
Okay.
I think this is. Can I have a look at that? The raincoat. I think that is definitely a seller. It is fantastic.
Yes. Can you imagine? It's
this
raining
is so
and
innovative.
Yes, I think
this
so
is
too.
So innovative. It is so different.
Yeah, and if you just look at the sewing, it's just it's done very nicely with double stitching. I'm telling you, no rain is gonna get on you when you're wearing this, and you're gonna look stylish in the rain.
But do you think the anchoring, can it get dirty?
No, because it's kind of I would say, you know,
can it be washed?
Yeah, cold wash, definitely. With the raincoats, because the fabric is, you can just wipe it.
You can wipe it, yes.
You can just wipe it. Because
yes.
the Ankara is enclosed in the
yes.
in the raincoat, so it's not. It's going to stay like that for... And, you know, we always looking to improve ourselves. So we're trying to find softer fabrics. You know, we like to look at fabrics all over the world. And that's what I mean. We don't just do the...
I need to just show my viewers again. This is really nice. This is really... I'm proud to have you on this. I think this is innovation. I think this is the way forward. I think we've got the right guest on our show to
Thank
talk
you.
About the business of fashion. Because if there's something that businesses thrive on, it's on products.
Yes.
So this is a unique product. It's different. I've never, ever... I've seen things similar
yeah.
to this, but I've never seen them with the...
The woven, the...
No, that, you put something, she took it off her waist.
Yeah, the belt, we call it, this is a kind of a something, our signature look. We like to weave, we've done different weaves with...
I've never seen that.
Leather, we've done leather and Ankara, we've done denim with Ankara. We just mixed it just to create a very unique look. That's what we do. And you know, if you notice, this has got pleats for women who are afraid of the tummy area. I know she's very slim, so she doesn't need to be afraid, but you know, that kind of just covers it up and it still gives you that cinched in look and, you know, just very...
Okay.
Yeah.
So are these samples or are they being sold somewhere?
This is a sample we've come to show you to
okay.
our viewers. Yeah, but we do have, I mean, whatever sizes you want, we do have it available.
Have them in stock.
Yeah, yes.
Okay, we'll talk about where we can get your stock later
okay.
on the show. But this is fantastic. I think there's no one in here to give a round of applause. So I'll do the round of applause, ladies. Fantastic.
Thank you.
We're going to go on another break now, and we'll be back shortly. So viewers, Jumoke has made another promise, so please go nowhere and watch out for her next promise. We'll be back shortly. Thank you.
Thank you.
We are back and we have Jumoke with us. I was wowed by her models. That was a big, big wow. And she's made another promise.
Yeah.
And that promise is we're going to have, what was it? Tell our viewers again.
Okay, so we're going to introduce different styles. I just want to give a view of what we do. When I mean that we have cutting edge styles, when I say we have trendy styles, when I say that we have out of the box style, I want you to know that the proof of the pudding is in its eating.
Wow.
So I brought my models here. They're kind of getting around for the second round. Yeah, so to come out. So we've got like, In Africa, we have different fabrics, like I mentioned. There's lace, there's Ankara, there's cotton. So I just want to see how we can mix it all together. So for parties and how the next look is going to involve wearing leather mixed with Ankara.
Let me stop you.
Okay.
You've used that word a lot, mix.
Yes.
Mix. It seems like that's a big thing with you. So why do you think mixing is... Is it part of your uniqueness, or is it what other designers do? Tell me about that. Why are you into this mix so much?
I think I would say it's part of my uniqueness. I think when you mix, you know, the African print in itself, just it's a showcase on its own. It's the master of the game, and then when you put it with other fabrics, it just accentuates it more. It just makes it come alive, and yeah. So I love mixing my fabrics. I love. Trying new, fabric mix. I love looking for new things that I can do with African fabrics. So yes, I just, you know, whether it be denim, whether it be, there's what they call the, I don't know if I'm pronouncing correctly, so forgive me, it's gingham, corduroy, scuba fabric. I just love mixing because I believe that as a designer, and you know, if I'm designing for you and you don't want African print, I should still be able to design for you. You know, I should still come out with stunning style. So I like to experiment with new fabrics. You know, if it's whether chiffon or lace. I know lace is a big thing now. If you go to all the stores now, it's called lace. But we do beautiful things with lace, and we. So yes, it is my.
Okay. Now here's my question. I've been listening to you,
yes.
And lips going on. I'm like, wow, and this is really good. I have a question, and I'm going to tilt it more towards the business side.
Okay.
There's you, obviously you're one of many,
yes.
Fantastic designers out,
yes.
There.
Yes.
But I don't know if you're part of a wider group, organization, or fashion designers. Well, the question I have is not just for you, but I'm trying to get your opinion. Mm-hmm. Perhaps you've discussed it with other fashion designers. Mm-hmm. And I really want to ask again, how are you, as a collective, mm-hmm. if you are, how are you pushing these brands to the forefront? Because you have to remember that it's one thing for you to create products. It's another thing for people to know where they are.
Yes.
You know, if you read my, have you read my book, 37 Business Thoughts?
I've read some of it. Yes.
If you read all
but,
of it.
Yeah.
There's some key principles around, yes. marketing. And one of them is I talk about visibility.
Yes.
Visibility,
yes,
visibility,
absolutely,
visibility.
Yeah.
And it's not always the best product that, mm-hmm. makes the most money.
Absolutely.
It's the most visible.
It's,
yeah. the one people can see, because, mm-hmm. that's the choice they're, mm-hmm. aware of. So they'll be like, I wasn't aware. You, mm-hmm. If I,
yeah.
had known,
yes.
I wouldn't have. So people are really into visibility. So my question really is, I mean, this is my first time I've seen that kind of raincoat, and I just thought of my daughter. Mm. I was like, immediately I thought of my daughter. And when I thought of her, I could see her friends. I want one.
Yes.
I could see them straight away, yeah. as in, this is the trend. Mm-hmm. This is the trend. But it's the visibility. Mm-hmm. What are you, or what are African fashion designers, mm-hmm. here or in Africa? Do you have a strategy? What are you doing to become much, much, much more visible,
yeah.
for the wider market to,
yeah.
see? If you don't have all the answers, don't worry. But
no.
I just want to hear.
And I think it's a very important question, mm. that you've asked me, because there's no point you having a good product and people don't get to see it.
Mm.
Yeah. So, I mean, I know I've done different things to get my product out there. I'm on Facebook, I'm on Twitter, I have a website, and of course I've joined a great business platform. And of course you've been helping me actually with you know, making myself visible, and it's been working, so I'm really happy with that. Also, you know, if you look at the product, and the first thing is I want to make it marketable to everybody. I think we've touched on that, to make it marketable to everybody. I go on fashion shows, and I have one scheduled for August and September, just to make myself out there. And I engage in you know, Google Analytics, just to get myself up there when there's a search. And I do a lot of, you know, also by recommendation. I'm so happy to say that some of my clients have come from recommendation.
Good.
So because I believe that, you know, mediocrity should not be part of our, you know, language at all. You know, we want to come up with good designs that is done very well, and good service as well to people, and making them happy. So most of my my products get out there because of people recommending me to say. And also our business model, I think, is very unique. We do ready to wear. You know, it's already ready to wear. We do bespoke as well. Of course, you know that we have to measure you and take longer. But we have a business model whereby you can do UK sizes. So imagine you want to go for Women for Africa, for example, and you're running late. You know, just as you know, your designer didn't come to you on time. You could have called me and said, Jumoke, hey, you know, can you hook me up with something? My size is so, 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 and so. And I would have hooked you up with something fantastic. And that's the thing that we're trying to create, a differentiation that way. You don't have to go and find the fabric. You don't have to go and look for tailors. You know, we take that from you. And also, if you decide that you like some of our designs, but you don't like the fabric, we've got, on our website, we've got an array of fabrics you can choose from and say, you know what, I like your design, but I don't like that, your fabric. I want this fabric, and then we'll accommodate that need. And I think that's creating a differentiation, a competitive advantage. I think that's very important. So I do go for, you know, we use, you know, the word of mouth. We use business forums like that. Technology to get ourselves out there. So we're planning on a big campaign. I know you, I know we've discussed it before. We're trying to start a new line with our shirt line. So we're going to go into a big campaign of, you know, dressing, you know, celebrities, you know, making ourselves more. We're going to go for more fashion shows. We're going to, you know, really, we've really put aside a budget for our marketing strategy.
Fantastic.
So we're going to work on that.
Okay. So talking about that, I can see there's some lovely ladies to my left, and I can see they're actually ready to come and show more. So what we're going to do is take a really quick break. Please stay with us, and we're going to come back in less than a minute, and we're going to show you some more of Jumoke's fantastic range. So viewers, stay there, and we'll be back shortly. Hey, we're back, just as promised, and Jumoke has wowed me again. You don't have to believe me. You see it for yourself. Over to you, Jumoke. What is this?
Okay, this is our, like, office look. It could be a formal wear.
Can I say something? When I look at those circles, like the 1960s, you know, straight away, Bob hairstyle, hip hop.
True.
I like that.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's true. So what we've done is, you know, we've used the background of black, and we just wanted to showcase the different colors. So we've kind of mixed all the different colors, but you know, it kind of works. We've got the yellows, and you just kind of done a circle. And we've done a crop jacket with it, Bonnie, thank you. If you just turn back, you see, if you look at the details.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Sorry about that. If you look at the detail on the sleeve of the jacket, you know, we just picked up on the African print there. We've done a pleat in there just to give it a different look, a unique look. And if you turn at, at the back, we've picked up all the spiral designs on the back of it as well. So it's quite unique. And, you know, we've got a pleat at the back just to pick up on the pleats at the sleeve of it. But if you take off the jacket for me, thank you. Let me help you. So you can wear it on its own, you know, heels will do the trick. Flats, that's fine, you know. But if you look at it, it's different. You know, it's different. And the good thing about this is that if we make one for you, because we like to use different Ankara, there's nothing like, oh, somebody stole my look, because we're going to give them something unique. And if they tell us, you know, we like yellow, so we just put a combination of yellow fabrics, you know. But this is just different. I mean, it's unique. You can, as far as I'm concerned, summertime, you can wear it to work. You can wear it to work. You can wear it for a party, and with or without a jacket. You know, it's just, I think it's just unique. And if you look at Adeola, you see what I told you about playing with fabrics. This okay. is fox leather.
Wow.
But wait, turn around. And there
wow.
we have the African print. So it's like, hello, I'm one thing, and turn back, it's something else. But if you look at this, it's very trendy right now. It is, you know, you can just see yourself, where would you wear this to?
I'm going to a party. Exactly. I've got a couple ones coming up, so I would definitely wear
this. See, there you go. So it's got a pocket and the gold details there, just to give it a... And I love the fact that it's kind of crisscross, just a design embedded in the leather itself, you know. We've embedded the treading just to create another effect to you. I don't know if the viewers can see that. There's a kind of crisscross on that. And if you look at the front panel, just to give it a different, unique look. So, I mean, tell me, you can see this. This will rival any design in the stores. I think so.
I have to agree. This is really good.
Yeah.
This is really good. I'm impressed. Yeah.
Yeah, I think so too.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Okay. So, are there any more after this?
Yes, Sam.
You have more?
Yes, we have more.
Okay. So now I'm beginning to be a bit more sober. Now listen. Okay. I'm still in the wow moment.
Yes. Yeah. You know,
can you just,
turn around.
Really.
So for people who don't want all the bold African print and they just want something different, I think this is good. And if you want it in all the different, in the same print as well, it's fine. And I think, you know, this one too is, you know, we can have different designs.
I love the 60s look.
Yes.
I straight away, like, bam, and he has all the colors.
So yes.
It's almost hippie.
Yeah, and you know what? You can decide, you can pick on any of those colors and accessorize with it. So if you want to go with pink accessories, if you want to go with blue, if you want to go with yellow, you know, it's a different outfit. If you want to wear it with this, if you don't want to, if you just want to wear it with the jacket, and you just imagine, you just want to wear the jacket with a jean. You want to go clubbing, and you just want to wear like a boot flare jeans and a white T-shirt, and you just put the crop jacket on top of it. Bob's your uncle.
You know fashion. You know fashion.
Yeah, you just, you know, because this is a statement piece on its own. You know, you just wear it, and people are like, ooh, you know, that's unique, you know? So that's what we're all about, uniqueness.
Okay, fantastic. Okay, I think the ladies can actually go now.
Yeah, thank you, Bonnie. Thank you, Adeola.
And prepare for the next round, because that is so exciting.
Yes.
And I thought I was going to be questioning you.
Yes.
And I'm finding that I'm actually listening and watching what you've done here. Okay. This is very, very inspiring. I like this because... straight away, what I can see here, and I'm sure what the viewers can see, is that there's so much creativity coming out. I did not realize you were going to have that much. Maybe for me, because my mother's a fashion designer, So I was born in a fashion house. So I have an eye for fashion, and I can see what was going on. That is a lot of detail. I'm very, very impressed. And I know that with the right type of visibility,
yes,
that those type of designs will sell like hotcakes.
Yes, you're right. Yeah, that's what we're working at right now, to get ourselves more visible to the public, and that's one of our strategies now. Because, like you said, there's no point having such a beautiful design and no platform to showcase it. And I'm thankful for this is a platform to
Fusion Plus Fusion, TV.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's a brilliant idea. Yeah, to showcase our stuff. So we want to go, you know, we have a dream to be in stores, you know, and, you know, be in retail shops. And I think I know we can do it.
Yes.
And yes, that's what we're working on. So we really are working on the marketing strategy where we can get ourselves out there. And yeah, just so people can see what we do and relate to it. And and I hope that what we've seen so far, people can see that it's anybody can wear it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I believe that.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know, that's why in like the dress Bonnie was wearing, we purposely did it in black. You know, like you can have it any color, but we did black because we wanted to showcase the African print and the different colors. And the black is just a platform to showcase it. So I think, yeah, that because also we want to appeal to across every spectrum, so to speak. Yeah.
Fantastic. Okay, tell me something. So, in the next coming weeks or months, do you have any shows or are there any events? Or are there any places that people can actually meet you if they wanted to talk to you? Or is it better just to go through your website? And by the way, what is your website address?
Our website address is www.arachnid, which is arachnid-creations.com. And before you ask me the question, I know you're going to ask me, why arachnid? You know, arachnid is a family of spiders. It's any eight-legged, you know, insect. Or
okay.
I hope nobody tweets you and say, oh, what is she talking about? But, you know, I think like spiders, I love spiders. I think like spiders, we spin up the web of creativity. We spin the web of fashion design. We just, you know, we spin innovation. I mean, it's just like, we do things like, you know, the three-in-one outfits where you can wear three ways. We actually go, we're just not creative. We want to be innovative as well. We don't want you to have a design whereby you wear it and if you don't have a party, you can't wear it out. We want you to be able to detach the top and wear the skirt to church, you know, to work, to, you know, for other things. So that's our website and, you know, and we also have our Twitter page. We've got a Facebook page as well.
Okay.
So if you just type in Arachnid Creations, you'll be able to get to our Facebook page. There are lots of pictures, there are lots of design. I can guarantee you'll find something that you like, definitely.
Right, fantastic. Okay, viewers, we're going to take a short break. And when we come back, Arachnid Designs have said they're going to show us more. This I want to see. So don't go away, and we'll be back with you shortly. Okay, people, we are back, and my guest this evening is Jumoke Ali, the founder of
Arachnid Creations.
The Spider Woman.
Yes.
When she said that, I thought to myself, Peter Parker, Spider-Man.
Yes.
And I was trying to remember Peter Parker's girlfriend. There was this girl, was it Jane?
Jane.
Jane. Are you a Jane?
Yeah.
Probably a Jane.
I'm a Jane, yeah.
Spider, what's going on? I like this. This is really good. But okay, you've wowed me again. These ladies have come out with something. So please take me and our viewers through what we're
doing. All right. So Bonnie is wearing a baby doll dress. And like I said about the mix of fabrics, this is, we're using lace with African print, and I'm just going to lift this up just to see what is underneath. And the reason why we've done, I know there's no color, really no color coordination there, but the reason is when you're looking at her, thank you, Bonnie, from whatever angle you see different colors. So there you see purple, you see the orange, you see the green. It's just, but it's muted by the white fabric. So this is a, you know, it's a very flatty, you know, when I talked about wearing it to, this you can wear to the park or, you know, shopping, you know, you can, where would you wear this, Bonnie?
Shopping,
yeah, or to your friend's place or something like that. Exactly.
Because when you said, really, I was afraid. What's she doing?
We layered the fabric with Ankara just because of the colors. I just love the colors that come through the whiteness of it. And of course, we've got the spiral. We've purposely chosen the fabric that's got holes in it so that it can showcase the fabric. So this is our baby doll dress. And of course, we've got African print, but you know, for people who don't like the color, they want something brighter, we can do that. And Adeola is wearing something similar, but like an A-line dress, but the embellishment is now at the waist.
What does an A-line dress mean?
An A-line dress is a dress that kind of goes out from the bust and just comes out there. So for people
like an A,
thank you.
Okay.
You know, for me, and it's for people like who don't want to, you know, their tummy, they think, you know, they want to, they don't want to show their tummy, or you know, they have
wide hips,
okay. yeah. So and again, we've embellished this with different African fabrics. With different layer of fabric, with different colors. I just love colors. But it's also muted because of the whiteness of it, and we just picked on this blue. So if you want to wear something, you can wear blue heels, you can wear white, you can accessorize with something different. So I think it's just, both of you turn around, thank you, so that the viewers can see the back.
Yeah, wow, this is so lovely. Nice.
And it's pleated, so it's got box pleats, and this is, and we've picked on the designs of the lace just to, and we've purposely left the Ankara coming through just to create a different color. Uniqueness. Yeah,
wow.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. So, how much would these sort of dresses, how much would they retail? I should have asked that for all of them, actually. Because I'm just like, what's going on here?
Yeah, I mean, they don't cost a ham and a leg. This will retail for like £70.
Okay.
And both of them. And we'll retail for £70, which I think it's...
What about the one before, the spiral one?
That's about £80.
Okay, and the double, the fox...
Oh, the fox one is about £120 because it's the leather. Yeah. So it's
what about the raincoat?
The raincoat, we're doing a sale now, actually. And so if you want to get that raincoat, you can actually get it for £80.
Okay.
Yes, because we sell it for £120. 120, 150, but we're doing a sale on for £80, and So we give you competitive prices. They're not like, you know, out of the world that you can afford it. And they're unique pieces, so it's something that it's the, you know, instead of going for the Gucci, which is good as well, but you know, have the arachnid.
Sure.
Let us arachnify
sure.
you.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, ladies. Thank you. Thank you. That's fantastic. And you're going to bring more out?
Yes, there's more. I was prepared for you, Sam.
Should I relax and let you take over? because this is... So tell me, what do you have? What kind of ranges do you have? Do you have like a summer range? What range is current now? And, you know, talk me through that.
Sam, that's a brilliant question. Because winter time, we actually had winter coats. We had winter coats which we embellished. We had put padding inside to insulate it so that it would give you some warmth. So we did have that for winter, and that's good. Now we have like, you know, full skirts with T-shirts. We have things like Bonnie and Diola just wore now, you know, party dresses. We have office wears. We have casual wears. And, of course, like I told you, we're coming out with a range of shirts. which will be for work, play, party. It's nothing like you've seen before, I promise you.
I'm beginning to believe you now. It's okay.
Yes.
Okay.
You know, we're going to have, you know, watch you. You're wearing something really nice. We're going to have something like that, but we're going to, you know, embellish you, Ankara Prince, and you can wear it to work. You can wear it for what you're doing now. Next time you're showing, you better be wearing one of our shirts.
Wow. Okay.
You know, so yeah, of course, when it's winter time, we tailor it more to the weather. It's long trousers and jackets and coats, and we do coats as well, winter coats, and we do also shoes. I didn't bring any of our shoes, but we do. If you go on website, we do have shoes as well that is being embellished with Ankara.
Wow.
Yes, and embellished with African prints and other fabrics as well. But very unique, very modern, very fashion forward, very trendy, that you can pair up with, you know, your outfit, and it will go just fine.
Wow, that is so interesting. That is so interesting. I mean, I'm sort of just like almost speechless. I mean, there is so much that you have there. And I'm thinking to myself that this is one designer. And there are probably so many of you out there. And, you know, we have to get you out to the public. And I know that this show, the good thing about this show is that it airs anywhere there's internet, which means it airs everywhere. We get viewers all over the world. So hopefully, before the end of this show, you will have a rise in people that will visit your website, your Twitter handle, your Facebook. Can you just mention those names again for your Facebook? What are the addresses?
So our website address is www.arachnid-creations.com. Facebook page, just type Arachnid Creations. And it will, thank you. It will come through. And also Twitter, it's @JAli@Arachnid.
Okay.
We've got our different pictures there as well. Yes, thank you. That's our Twitter page. Okay. Fantastic. And you can see the spider. I love that spider. And so we're also on Instagram.
Okay.
If you type Arachnid, it will come up with our Instagram pictures. So you can reach us anywhere, everywhere.
Okay.
That's the plan.
Okay.
So please do contact us. I look forward to styling everybody out there. And I just say, you know, just give us a try and let's see. Because I know that if I do a good job, people will recommend me. And so I'm really ready to, you know, I say to my husband sometimes, I say, stand back, you know, I'm ready to bust out of my seams with fashion ideas. So I'm ready to just, you know, I'm always pushing the envelope. I want to, like I said before, if it's someone that wants to be a wallflower and doesn't want to stand out and just wants to do what everybody else is doing, well, you know, okay. But if you want to stand out, you want something really trendy, something that unique, because I think everybody wants to stand out. Mm. I think so. We will do that. We'll sort you out in a good way.
Fantastic. Tell me about this shirt.
Okay, this is actually one of our designs. As you can see, if you look at the details of the shirt, it's got cufflinks, so you can actually put some cufflinks in.
Did you make the cufflinks as well?
No. And you know, if you look at the details of the shirt, you know, the buttons are covered, so you can cover it up. And like I said, if you think the color, because I love bright colors, if you think, oh, it's too much, wear a black pullover and a crop top with some jeans. I've worn this to work several times. Summertime, I've worn it to work just by itself. And yeah, it is a tailored fit. We do tailored fit. And I just wish the viewers can see the stitching and the details that have gone into it. It's actually, yeah, this is some of the shirt collections I will be bringing out later.
Okay, fab. And your next set of designs on your models, are you going to tell us about them?
Yes. This is, should we bring them up first?
Yep.
Before I start?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. So if you look at this, this is a double-breasted jacket. And you can see we've embellished it with...
What material is that?
It's called polyester. It's a mixed fabric, actually. It's polyester and lycra and the cotton together. We definitely like to source for fabrics that are unique. I love the futuristic, I mean, look at the pleatings there. I love the futuristic look, the silver details on it, you know, the, of course, our logo. And, you know, it's just, I deliberately paired it with a skirt because I'm thinking, you know, you want to go, like, after work for with your colleague to the pub or whatever. And, you know, you can just wear this as it is, you know. Or you want to go shopping or whatever. And then, if you turn back, let me see if I can reach out. The magic is in there. Oops. Sorry, Bonnie. Okay. I think it's caught on the zip. Oh. Sorry, viewers. While I sort this out. Okay, good.
Wow.
And we've got a hood, which is tucked in. Put on the hood for us.
Wow.
And, you know, I just say, imagine, Sam, you're going for a party. See, and it's, you know, a barbecue. And you can just pin that up, wear long jeans, slim-fitted jeans with killer high heels. And you just go, thanks, Bonnie. Just look at the details of it. I mean, this is beautiful. This is not something I know you've seen before. I can, because this is designed, just one of our new designs. And you just, you know, you just go out there with looking like this. People are bound to say, you know, just Bonnie, come to the front line. I want the viewers to see this. Yeah. And if you look at
even before you go to Adele, I was going to say something.
Yes.
While you were pulling up the zip and taking it out, a thought came to me. I remember what you said earlier. You said your colleague at work said, "Why are you here? You're wasting the talent."
Yes.
And I just thought to myself, "Where has this woman been? This is so creative."
Thank
your
you.
Colleague was right.
Yes.
You need to. This is fantastic. Yeah. So well
Thank
done.
You, Sam. Thank
okay.
You. And this is what I like to call crazy shirt, but not in a bad way.
Okay.
You know, because we mix different. This is for people who just wanna, you know, everything else is black, mm-hmm. and you just showcase this colorful Ankara, the different ones. And now we have our button detail. And if you've noticed something, we've got the embroidery.
Wow.
You know, back home, I'm sure you know, we have this embroidered flowing gowns, and normally we don't put it on shirts, we put it on the flowing gowns or the kaftans, but I've picked on that trend because I think it's beautiful, and I've put it on my shirt and on the collar as well. If we have different ones, we pick on the different colors, something to just pop out, something to just stand out, something different.
Something important. Can you believe we only have 4 minutes left in this show?
Oh.
If you can change in 2 minutes, you can show us the last one. If you can't, we're going to have to stop. But if you can,
I'm sure they can.
As fast as you can, we've got 4 minutes left. This is exciting.
Yes, Sam.
Yeah.
Thank you.
This is exciting. Okay, so I just fell out. Buy that for my daughter. This is really good.
Yeah, yeah.
Hmm.
I mean, the shirts, we're gonna explore more on something that will appeal for work, something that will appeal for if you want to go for a party. Like I said, I mentioned embellishing our shirts with rhinestones, and am I pronouncing correctly? Yeah, diamantes and Swarovski's crystals. That would just, you know, something that, you know, when you're going for, like, Women for Africa, you can just wear it and with a nice trousers, and, you know, you just stand out equally, and you could put in your head wrap with it. And, yeah, so we're just pushing we're looking to push the envelope, and we are going to get there, yeah?
Absolutely fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Okay, so I can see your girls have come back with another change. Let's quickly see what they've got on before, you know, our 2 minutes completely disappears.
Yes. I mean, look at Bonnie. Bonnie is wearing our kimono-inspired look. And so if you show the hands, Bonnie, this is just one we've done with Ankara. It's got pockets, and this is inspired by the Japanese kimono. That's just the.
Do you actually know how beautiful this is? I'm actually. Do his arms again. Look at that.
Yeah.
This is fantastic.
And we've worn a petticoat with this just to show that, you know, we want you to be versatile. You know, you can do it without a petticoat. And you wonder, you know, this is a statement piece. This is where you walk into a party and people will say, where did you get that from? This is what I want. That's the reaction I want every time people put on our designs. I want people to go, where did you get that from? Who thought about this, you know?
Definitely.
Yeah, and it's
and
got the
hood.
It's got a, I love my hood. And I don't know if you've noticed, I just love hood.
Spider-Woman loves it.
Yes, I just love the hood. And, you know, you can pin that in your hair just before going to a party. Just pin
what
it there.
Pin it?
You know, you can just pin it there and walk into a party. So it's always on your head. You know, you have a bun, you just pin it there, and you walk into a party and you just, this is unique. If you turn back, yeah, it's just fantastic. And you can wear it with leggings, you can wear it with jeans, you know, it's versatile, but it's this is one of our statement pieces.
Wow.
Yeah. And if you look over there, this is an evening dress.
Is this the queen?
This is exactly, this is an evening dress. You know, people, there's prom season now. And I say, don't go and get these expensive prom dresses. Get something unique where people will forever remember what you're wearing. I mean, look at this. We've embellished it at the side with Ankara, with African print. And we've picked, it's actually, this is removable. We can remove this.
What is removable?
The jacket. I don't know if you're, is it?
What do you mean jacket?
Yeah. Oh. Remove it and make it into one shoulder. No, it's okay, yeah. So if you wanted to remove it, you can, you know, so we've made the lace.
I'm impressed.
Yeah, and we just put the zip is actually just for decoration, but it's just to showcase. You know, this was inspired by the Gladiator. This is what I say, I mean by, I just pick my inspiration from, I saw the Gladiator movie, and I thought, I just love the leather, and we started incorporating leather with Ankara, and I just love the fact that it's very, you know, it's a dress, an evening gown, but it also there's a bit of structure to it with the one shoulder, and then you can put a jacket on it, you know. And people think it's just, you know, but yeah. Turn around, let's see. It's beautiful.
Wow, absolutely beautiful. Jumoke, you've taken all the time. The hour's gone. I can't actually believe the whole hour has evaporated, and it only seems like 5 minutes. Okay. Look, you know what? Before we go, I want you to just tell our viewers where they can actually see your designs. Just tell us your website again, your Facebook. We know you're... Well, one thing I do know is that on the 18th of June, at our next business club meeting in Hendon, are you coming?
I will definitely.
So definitely, Jumoke will be. That's one place I'm sure you can see her. But please tell us your website again, Facebook, and everything else.
Our website address is www.arachnid-creations.com, and if you go to Facebook and type in Arachnid Creations, you'll find it there. And Arachnid is spelled A-R-A-C-H-N-I-D, and on Twitter we are jali@arachnid. And Instagram, if you type in Arachnid, you will find us. So please visit us. I'm looking forward to styling you, definitely.
Wow. Viewers, I'm impressed. I really, really, really liked what you had there. And I'm afraid our time is up this week. But I'd like to thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any questions, you've heard her address. If not, send it to us and we'll forward it to her. So until the next time we come, this is your host, Sam Unigbanjo here, GBP Business Club, signing out for the hour. Have a great week. If you want to read anything, read 37 Business Thoughts. You can get it at samunigbanjo.me. Take care, good night, and God bless. Bye-bye.